Gracie in St. Louis, as promised, welcome to the show. Hi, Gracie.
Hi. Thank you for taking my call.
You're welcome.
So I have a question. I'm searching, and I just have a lot of questions. And one question I have is, you know, let's say I choose hell, and I get that that's my choice.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, I choose hell, but I murdered, a dozen people in this life, and then I turn my back on God finally.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't, like, 1,000 years of hell enough justice for my bad choice? Why does it have to be an eternal choice? Like, you know, at the very end, I get one choice,
mm-hmm.
repent or not, and then it's an eternity of
right.
hell. That I don't get that.
Well, Gracie, I think I would answer your question this way. We as human beings have immortal souls, and God has revealed to us that not only will our souls survive death, but we will be reunited with our bodies and we will live forever. So the problem is, when we make choices in the next life, it's a choice forever in one direction or another, either for God or against Him. There's also...
Why? Why does it have... I mean, is it like a final? Why can't it just be like,
mm-hmm.
okay, I chose it, suffered for 1,000 years for,
term prison sentence.
Let me give you an analogy. There's two different ways I could respond to this. Number one, it's possible that the reason hell is eternal isn't because God chooses that for us. It's because people who are in hell continue to choose to reject God, and their hatred for Him and hatred for goodness builds and builds and builds, and they just never choose Him, and they continue to sin and always choose to be apart from Him. Would you agree that that is possible? Have you ever known someone who's just stubborn and keeps going down the wrong path just to make a point? Do you see how that's possible?
Sure.
Okay. Sure. So it's possible the reason hell is eternal, God doesn't make it eternal. It's possible we as sinners, when we reject God, our desire for evil makes it eternal because of what we want. That's number one. Number two, I think it would be almost, there's a sense of injustice here if people, evil that's in this life, you know, is punished in hell only temporarily and then spends heaven with everyone else, even people who hate God or hate goodness. Here's the situation. So, Gracie, suppose I just went to Disneyland, actually, with my family. I have one child. But suppose I had two children and we're getting ready to go into Disneyland and my son punches his sister in the eye. And I say to him, all right, buddy, you are going to be punished. I am grounding you for the next 5 seconds, and then we're going to go to Disneyland for the whole day. All right, you're done. All right, we can go. What would you think of that as a punishment?
Well, yeah, that's not fair.
But,
you haven't asked him, though. He thinks it's fair.
Oh, he probably thinks it's very fair. But notice, Gracie, it's unfair, would you agree, because the length of the punishment and its duration and intensity is so much less than the reward he's about to get, the spending the whole day at Disneyland, right?
Right.
But wouldn't there be, if 5 seconds waiting in line versus a whole day at Disneyland, actually, if you think about it, 1,000 years in hell is a much smaller time compared to the infinity we'll spend in heaven.
Right.
So you see how both those reasons could add up to explain why in hell the only just and understandable way is that it's a permanent choice people make?
Yes, I can see that.
Okay.
But it's
tough. I mean, it's still an awful thing to... I'm not saying it's a horrifying reality to think of. It's horrifying. Mm-hmm. But I would recommend, though, that it's something to think about, mm-hmm. and think that if we choose God and we choose His goodness, that should impel us to flee from that with all of our might.
Gracie, thank you very much for the call. A lot of people stay atheist because of this hard saying of Jesus.
Yes.
But Trent, is part of our issue, part of our problem, that we see things in terms of time as we experience it here below,
right?
Before, during, after. Is hell one long, you know, arduous, infinite line of experience, exactly like here on Earth, but with, you know, flames and pitchforks?
Well, the Catechism says that that what's used to describe both heaven and hell, symbolic images are used.
Mm-hmm.
For example, when the New Testament speaks about fire, that may be literal. It may not be, though, because it also talks about hell being a kind of outer darkness, and fire creates light. So what could this be? What the church has defined, though, what hell is eternal separation from God. And what that's like, what we will be persons in heaven and hell, will experience a passage of time, because being human beings, we need that passage of time to make sense of reality. But it may not be the same kind of it may be different. Mm-hmm. We may not fully understand what that's like. But I would say that it's not going to be like just your worst experience here on earth stretched out over an indefinite period of time. So that is something to consider, though. What it would be like, we all have tried to understand from this side of the veil, and we will only understand on the next side. But yeah. I hope when it comes to hell, we don't understand it firsthand.
Yeah. Yeah, me too.
That's why we always have to pray. We have a confidence, if we are in a state of grace, that we will be with Christ for eternity, but not a 100% false sense of assurance.
Gotcha. Congratulations on your book, Grace.